Session 4, Advanced Git. What you will understand, what you learn in this session. Rebasing, what is it? Interactive rebasing, cherry picking, resetting and reverting, stashing. All these are the interesting topic, advanced topic of Git, and you'll understand these topics in this session. Rebasing. What is Git rebase? If you go by dictionary meaning, that itself says you that you want to go back and rebase yourself to some other commit. Like you are working here, you're working on this branch, you reach to some stage, but you want to rebase yourself. This was main branch going on, and you want to, these are the features, for example, something which you want to rebase yourself and to implement yourself here. And you want to ignore some of the commits. So you want to rebase. So let's understand this. Rebasing is what? It's a process of moving or combining a sequence of commits to a new base commit. So that which essentially means it is changing the base of your branch from one commit to another, making it appear as if you have created your branch from a different commit. So which essentially, again, if I emphasize on it, I'm saying that you committed, you are working here, these are features, and you want to rebase yourself at this set of features at when you reach to this point. So you rebase and you are working here. That is the point the rebase is concerned about. Internally, Git accomplishes this by creating new commits and applying them to the base. That is the point. So you are working here. Look at how it works. It works that you are working here. These were the two additional commits. So these two commits applied here. So you moved here internally. This is how it works. So from this main, this branch had some additional features applied. You apply those changes here and you reach here with this advanced features. So you rebase yourself at this feature. Whereas you separate out your branch from this point, and these two commits are different from this sequence of commit. So that's the precise concept. So internally, Git will accomplish this by creating new commits and applying them to the specified base. Even though the branch looks the same, it is composed of entirely new commits. Uses. Why do we need to use it, and when do we need it? What are the use cases? To maintain a linear project history is the use case, is the uses, when do we use it, and this is the situation, this is the scenario where you can use it. To maintain a linear project history, the benefit of having a clean history becomes tangible when performing Git operations to investigate the introduction of regression. For example, a bug is identified in the main branch. That's a good use case. Just understand this. A bug is identified in the main branch. A feature that was working successfully is now broken, not working. A developer examined the history of main branch using Git log. Because of the clean history, the developer is quickly able to reason out about the history of the project. The developer cannot identify when the bug was introduced using Git log, so the developer execute Git bisect. Now, because Git history is clean, Git bisect has a refined set of commits to compare when looking for the regression. The developer quickly finds the commit that introduced the bug and is able to act accordingly. This way, Git will reuse you, as a developer, will rebase yourself with new commits, the correct commits. Integrating your features into main branch. You have two options. One, merging directly, or rebasing then merging. Which one is to be used and why? Which one is beneficial? The former option results in a three-way merge and a merge commit, while the latter results in a fast-forward merge and a perfectly linear history. Let's understand rebasing with fast forward. How fast forward merge works. Rebasing is a common way to to integrate upstream changes into your local repository. Pulling in upstream changes with git merge results in a superfluous merge commit every time you want to see how the project has progressed. On the other hand, rebasing is like saying I want to base my changes on what everybody has already done. I want to move fast forward, or I want to rebase myself, which internally you know very well that Git is going to apply all those commits what others have done. Rebasing, rebase standard versus rebase interactive. Git rebase interactive is when git rebase accept hyphen I argument. Means it makes it interactive. Interactive means you will decide. There are single character commands. Let's assume that you created a separate feature branch. Create a feature branch base of the main. Git checkout hyphen b feature branch main. Now edit some files. These are some edit, and after that you commit them. Git rebase is standard mode. In standard mode, will automatically take the commits in your current working branch and apply them to the head of the past branch. And that will be git rebase to rebase branch name where you want to rebase yourself. Git rebase interactive. How git rebase interactive works? Running git rebase with hyphen I flag begin an interactive rebasing session. It gives you the opportunity to alter individual commits in the process. This lets you clean up history by removing, splitting, and altering an existing series of commits. The command is simple: git rebase hyphen hyphen interactive or single character hyphen I and the base where you want to rebase yourself. So what happens is you can alter individual commits and this decide which one you want to apply. Look at the example commands. P command, single character command. P stands for pick, which means use this commit. R means reword, use commit but edit the commit message. E means edit, use commit but stop for amending. Hyphen S means squash, means use commit but meld into previous commit. Hyphen F, fix up like squash but discard this commit's log messages. Hyphen X, exec, means run the command the rest of the line using shell. And D means drop, remove the commit. These are single character rebasing edit commands. Interactive rebasing, the same thing. It gives you the opportunity to alter commits as they are moved to the new branch. It is used to clean up a messy history before merging a feature branch into main. To begin an interactive rebasing, you first check out git checkout feature, the branch name, then git rebase hyphen I main, and now you pick and choose and apply. This will open a text editor using all of the commits that are about to be moved. So this will show you all the commit with VI editor. All this will open a text editor using these commits. So this is first pick this commit, a message for commit one, pick this one, message for this, and this another for message this. These are three commits which are there from where you can decide and edit and choose and apply. This listing defines exactly what the branch will look after the rebase is performed and giving you opportunity to add it. By changing the pick command or reordering the entries, you can make the branch history look like whatever you want. For example, the second commit fixes a small problem in the first commit. You can condense them into a single commit with fix up command. So you can apply this commit pick, instead of pick you can type fix up, and the message for commit number 2 you can specify the message also. This will make the change the command in the editor itself. So this is what will happen when you save and close the file. Git will perform the rebase according to instructions resulting in a project history that will look like this. This was your main branch, branch new commit. This is the contains the contents of first and second commit. These are the features which you applied, and then eliminating significant insignificant commit like this make your features history much easier to understand. This is something that Git merge simply cannot do, and rebasing is possible in that. Merge will not help you with this. Cherry pick is much more advanced. It's like picking up what you want to. You have multiple commits. You want to pick which one will make your history clean, which will make your code meaningful. Git cherry pick enables arbitrary Git commits to be picked by reference and appended to the current working head. That means you can go and pick up from other and apply that, append that to the current head. Cherry picking is the act of picking a commit from branch and applying it to another. Git cherry pick can be useful for undoing changes. For example, say a commit is accidentally made to the wrong branch. You can switch to the current branch and cherry pick the commit where it should belong. The same commit you can apply to the current branch where you want to be, where you want it to be. When to use Git cherry pick? Team collaborations. Sometimes a team find members working around the same code. Maybe a new product feature has a backend and front-end component. The front-end developer could use Git cherry pick to pick up the commit in which the data structure was created, and this pick would enable the front-end developer to continue progress on their side of the project. Another use case is hot bug fixes, bug hot fixes. For example, a developer has started work on a new feature. During that, they identify a pre-existing bug. The developer creates an explicit commit patching this bug. This new patch commit can be cherry-picked directly to the main branch to fix the bug before it affects more users. Third use case is undoing changes and restoring lost commits. Sometimes a feature branch may go stale and not get merged into main. Git never loses these commits, and through commands like git log and git ref log, that is reference log, they can be found and cherry picked back to life. So how do you use this git cherry pick? Let's assume that you have a repository with this branch state. Branch, this is the main branch A, B, C, D. From here you created a new branch E, F, G. This is a new feature branch going on. Git cherry pick is used as straightforward and can be executed like git cherry pick commit SHA. Like that, the sequential. In this example, this commit SHA is a commit reference. You can find a commit reference using git log. In this example, let's say you wanted to use commit F in main. Means only this much. You want to commit this into main. So first we ensure that we are working on the main branch, that is git checkout main. So this confirms that yes, we are working in main branch. Then we execute git cherry pick with this command git cherry pick F. Once we executed git history, it will look like this. The F was applied here, which was earlier up to here. Now the main branch will be A, B, C, D, F. And this is where we are. The F commit has been successfully picked into the main branch. This is a very simple example of git cherry pick. Git reset versus git revert. When maintaining code using virtual control systems, it is unavoidable that we need to roll back some wrong commits, either due to bugs or temp code revert. Two major ways used frequently by developers are git reset and git revert. Let's understand what are they. Git reset. Assume that we have these commits A, S8F8X and B and C and D. Our head is here. Commit A and B are working commit, but C and D are bad commits. Now we want to roll back to commit B and drop commit C and D. Currently head is pointing to commit D. We just need to point head to commit B to achieve that what we want. So the easy to do the command is git reset --hard and the commit name, that is the A0FVF8, that is the this commit B. Git reset. After executing above command, head will point to B. Now we are here. But now the remote origin still has head point to D. If we directly use git push to push changes, it will not update the remote repo. We need to add -f option to force pushing the changes. That is git push -f. Git revert. The use of git revert is to create a new commit which reverts a previous commit. The head will point to new reverting commit. For example, in the git reset above, we need to do this just reverting commit D and then reverting commit C. So what we do is we git revert and the commit name, that is 51k4er, that is 51 or 5lk4er. So we revert to this and revert this one individually, this also, and then we apply the next one D' and C'. Now we create two new commit D' and C'. That is revert. So what is the what if there are lots of commits to revert? Assuming that we have three, we can revert a range indeed. Like you can use git revert older commit. This is a newer commit we want to apply. Assuming that we have three commits, but the bad commits is the second commit. Means we want to apply three, but this is bad commit. So A is okay, C is okay, B is bad. We need to keep commit C because it is a good commit. Now we can revert commit C and B and then cherry pick to commit C again. So what we do, we use first C and then B and cherry pick that C here again. That is cherry picking this. Difference between git reset and git revert. Git reset will reset the state of the branch to a previously state by dropping all the changes post the desired commit. Git revert will reset to a previous state by creating new reverting commits and keep the original commit. It's recommended to use git revert instead of git reset in enterprise environment. Git reset versus git revert versus checkout. This is the reference of all the commands what we use. Git reset command, scope is commit level, common use cases discard commits in a private branch or throw away uncommitted changes. Git reset is file level and unstage the file. Git checkout, commit level, switch between branches or inspect old snapshots. Git checkout, file level, discard changes in the working directory. Git revert is commit level, undo commits in a public branch, and git revert is file level. Stashing and cleaning. Often you've been working on part of your project. Things are in a messy state. When you want to switch branches for a bit to work on something else. The problem is you don't want to do a commit for half done work. So just so you can get back to this point later. The answer is to issue a git stash command. The stashing takes the dirty state of your working directory and save it on a stack of unfinished changes that you can reapply at any time. So go into your project and start working on a couple of files and possibly stage one of the changes. If you run git status, you can see your dirty state, like your git status, change to be committed. You see that here, modified file is this, changes not staged for commit. You'll see the commands also and modified files. Now you want to switch branches. You don't want to commit what you have been working on yet. So you'll stash the changes. To push new stash onto your stack, just run git stash or git stash push. So git stash, saved working directory and indexed state. You will get the details also, and hash is now on this commit, create index file to restore them, you can type git stash apply. Now you can see your working directory is clean, git status, on branch master, nothing to commit, working directory is clean. At this point, you can switch branches and do work elsewhere. Your changes are stored on your stack. To see what stashes you have stored, you can use git stash list and you will see all your commits. Stash 0, stash 1, stash 2. These are your commits with the messages. In this case, two stashes were saved previously. So you have access to three different stashes worked, stashed works. You can reapply the one you just stashed by using the command shown in the help output of the original stash command, that is git stash apply, what was listed in the previous slide if you recollect. That was given here, git stash apply. If you want to apply one of the older stashes, you can specify it by naming it like git stash apply stash at the rate 2. So you want to apply stash number 2. If you don't specify a stash, git assume that most recent stash and try to apply it. Git stash apply, I'll try to apply the most recent. The changes to your file were reapplied, but the file you staged before was not restaged. To do that, you must run the git stash apply command with a hyphen hyphen index option to tell command to try to reapply the staged changes. So if you had run that instead, you'd have gotten back your original position, to your original position, like git stash apply hyphen hyphen index, on branch master changes to be committed, git reset head, you have to use this to unstage modified file, and not staged to for commit, use this command to update that will be committed. All these commands and details you will get in the output. The apply option only tries to apply the stashed work. You continue to have it on your stack. To remove it, you run git stat drop command. Git stash drop stash number. For example, you want to drop this stash at the rate 0. So you can use git stash drop this, and this stash will be dropped. That's all for this session. Thank you very much.